a storytelling initiative about the brave hearts of India.
So I'm going to begin you with the story of Major Mohit Sharma. And, you know, I'm glad to inform that few of Mohit's batchmate from Army is also watching this FB Live. And I've been told that this video would be shared with Mohit's parents and Mohit's brother. So I'm really privileged and proud to host this session, this storytelling session. And glad and I'm 100% sure that after hearing these stories, many of the kids would like to join Armed Forces, which has got a wonderful career option. And had taken a career session online a week back where 16 families have joined. A lot of kids were there. And just to keep that enthusiasm up, I am bringing you a storytelling about two of them. So the part two, first story is about Major Mohit Sharma, Ashok Chakra, posthumous. And that too at the age of 30, you know. So the story goes, way back when Mohit was posted in 2004 at a place called Shopia, that is around J&K. And trust me, the story which I'm going to tell you is a story of real daredevilry. I mean, you can't think of somebody doing that. So there were two terrorists from the Jaish, and they were holed up in this place somewhere around Shopia. And these two terrorists, they were just watching the valet in a small hut. They were sitting there and they were discussing amongst themselves, carrying a Kalashnikov in their sling. And they were discussing something about the third person sitting there. And the third person was again dressed in a Kashmiri, you know, like Kashmiri attire. And both of them wanted to know more about him. And then they started asking him, ki bhai tu kaun hai, like tu yahan kya kar. And this guy, the third one, he was serving them the kawa and then occasional food, and he never used to speak much. So they were very curious on why a terrorist is not speaking much. And then they happened to you know, they tried their best to speak him. And then hi Ashish. So one fine day they just decided to ask him, who are you? And then they knew his name was Iftikhar Bhatt. They asked him, what is the reason that bring him to be a terrorist, you know? And then this guy coolly says that my brother was killed by the army personnel in the valley. And yes, t-shirt, this depicts the forge, so I'm wearing it. It's a own t-shirt. So he was very vocal about his brother being killed by the army personnel. Then he said, mujhe to bas badla lena hai, isliye main yahan par hoon. And these two terrorists, they were a very known terrorist, and they had you know, prize on their head. And after a few days, this guy told both of these terrorists that या तो तुम मुझे मदद करो या मुझे जाने दो. अगर तुम मुझे मदद करोगे तो मुझे ये आर्मी वालों को उड़ाना है. एंड दे हैड एंड दिस गाय हैड ऑल द मैप्स एंड टेरेन्स ऑफ वे द आर्मी पर्सनल आर इन दैट पर्टिकुलर एरिया. सो व्हाट हैपेंड वाज, स्टिल दिस टू टेररिस्ट हैड डाउट हु दिस थर्ड पर्सन वाज. एंड देन ऑन द 10th डे, सी इमेजिन, आई एम जस्ट mark this time, 10th day. So this guy was staying with these two terrorists for 10 days. And on the 10th day, they asked, ki bhai tu kaun hai, bata. And phir kya hota hai ki suddenly this guy gets up, the third guy, the Iftikhar guy, he gets up. He say, bhai jaan, agar aapko itna hi shak hai mujh pe, to ye lo mera banduk. He was carrying a kalash and he drops his kalash now. And he says, अगर इतना ही मेरे पे आप लोग को शक है तो मुझे मार दीजिए. So both the terrorists couldn't decide anything. And by the time these two guys could take any action, so this guy drops his Kalashnikov from his shoulder and takes a assault rifle from his back and shoots both of the terrorists. Dono ko khatam wahin pe seedha thok diya. And then sitting there on one of the terrorist dead body, he sips his tea, the kava, finishes it, and next few days he's back to his army unit. And that is Major Mohit Sharma. So this guy stayed with the terrorist, was there with them for 10 days in the disguise of a Kashmiri terrorist, and then the first opportunity killed both of them. So now this story, this particular incident in 2004, it's a folklore. It's a folklore in the army. You know, like anybody who joins special forces has to listen to this story of Mohit. You know, such was, I mean, it's impossible for someone to do such a act of daredevilry. And that too when he was, you know, like 2004, he would have been 26 or 27. So that's Major Mohit Sharma. So this was one of the stories, and this is just after he became a special force commando. So Mohit was born to a middle class family like most of us, and I have the privilege when I say that Mohit is 6 months junior to me in services, equivalent rather. So 99, when we were commissioned, that was the time when Mohit was also commissioned in army. So Mohit was from a very middle class family like all of us. And then Mohit has a brother, Madhur. Madhur had tried giving the SSB exams for army, but like any other parents, his parents were also very skeptical. They both are government employees, very skeptical of Mohit joining the forces. And then like any parents, like all of us, some path was chalked to us. They also wanted him to do engineering. So Mohit went and did his engineering. He enrolled for engineering in a college in Maharashtra. So, but then his heart was always there. He wanted to be in forces, period, you know, like kaise bhi. So the first step to the armed forces after 12. So in the armed forces, there are officer cadre and the soldier cadre. So to go into the officer cadet, so it's like either you have to go to NDA where you can bifurcate into Army, Navy, Air Force, or you have a Army Technical Services entry after 12th, or you have a Naval Academy 12th after 12th, and then a Air Force Academy exam. So this is the way you go through the armed forces, which I had taken in a session few days back. So Mohit also gave his NDA exams. Though his parents was aware of he giving an NDA exams. So when Mohit went to engineering college, and there, but then his heart was always there ki yaar mujhe fauj jana hi hai karke, you know. And then when the result came of NDA, the result came into his to his house. So his parents never told him whether he has cleared that exam. So being in that engineering college, Mohit was always very, like wanted to be there. And then he was doubting ki kuch to gadbad hai, you know, like, and then he called the SSB office there. And then he came to know that he has cleared his NDA exams and he has been called for SSB. Wahan se, trust me, wahan se, like any parent, all of us, aajkal aise hai ki, as a parent, बच्चों को फौज में जाना नहीं है because most of our parents wants not to expose you in the front line. All of us, you know, like, but then that's what parents are. But then कुछ होते हैं, बच्चे भी ऐसे होते हैं कि जिद करके जाना है. Mohit was one of them. So Mohit went to SSB Bhopal, and after 5 days of grueling SSB interview and then medical, he got selected to do his course from NDA Pune Khadakwasla. So this was one part of Mohit's story, and this is how he got into academy. And Mohit excelled in all the spheres in NDA. That is, he was good at studies, good at sports, good at, everything, boxing, swimming, whatever you say, Mohit was good. And then he was one of the best cadets in NDA. So once his tenure in NDA was over, he went on to pass from IMA, Indian Military Academy. So that was somewhere in December 99. And trust me, that was the peak time when Kargil War was happening, you know. And then all of Mohit's and Mohit's batchmate who were in NDA, they used to hear this news of Kargil War happening. And tabhi unko, when you are in academy or when you are there, and when that was the time we were in academy, Naval Academy, INA, and you could hear about Kargil War going, and then most of us was to be posted out of academy, and then you were, that Josh of being a young officer. I'm sure Mohit would also be going through that same situation. So he always wanted to be there at the front. So when he passed out from IMA, so one of his batchmates asked him, जैसे casually होता है ना कि मोहित अब कहाँ जाने की posting होगी, do you have any inclination, किधर जाना है? So this was his answer, just see, his answer was simple, like मुझे वहाँ जाना है मैं जहाँ terrorist को मार सकूँ. So very very clear, crisp and clear. There is no nothing कि मुझे ये posting वहाँ जाना है मुझे जहाँ मैं टेररिस्ट को मार सकूँ. एब्सोल्युटली क्लियर. सो दैट इज वॉट गॉट मी अट्रैक्टेड. आई री रेड हिज स्टोरी एंड ट्रस्ट मी, एट सम पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम आई वॉज हैविंग टीयर्स इन माई आईज वेन हिज द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ हिज स्टोरी वेन आई एक्सप्लेन यू दैट हैपेंड. सो देर आफ्टर ही वॉज पोस्टेड इन जे एंड के इन 1999 एंड he was there for 1.5 years in JNK, and that was the time he used to patrol there along with the special forces officer. So he was not from the special force. Special force are the commandos. They undergo tough training. Agar sare fauji strong hai, to commandos are one notch upper. They wear the maroon beret. They have this Balidan badge, and that is there in Navy as well as Air Force. The Marine Commandos, the Marcos, and Air Force may they called Garuds. So in the first part of this book, there are a couple of stories about naval officer, the Marine Commandos. And then I was very privileged to be posted in a commando base for my first part of my career. And there I happened to be friends with Varun Singh, now captain. His story may be in the next time when I'll explain you. So coming back to Mohit. So Mohit was posted there. So जब भी ये वहाँ patrolling करता था, because lot of terrorist activities, that is the time he realized कि नहीं, मुझे special forces में ही जाना है, मुझे commando ही बनना है. So now what? अब commando बनना है तो क्या? So he asked one of the special forces officer there, do you think मुझ में वो बात है क्या कि मैं commando बन पाऊँ? So the reaction was immediate from the other officer who was from the special forces. उसका ये कहना था कि यार यहाँ बड़े बड़े लोग आते हैं टू ट्राई फॉर दी स्पेशल फोर्सेस, बहुत धुरंधर आते हैं और वो भी नहीं क्लियर कर पाते, और बहुत ऐसे ही लोग नॉर्मल लोग आ जाते हैं एंड देन दे गेट दे प्रूव टू बी वेरी वेरी स्ट्रांग. सो दैट्स हाउ, अगर तुम्हें खुद का जानना है तो यू हैव टू अटेम्प्ट दिस attempt for being in special forces. Now special forces, it requires very tough training, very very tough training of say duration I guess 6 to 9 months. And if you have seen the movie Prahar, agar aapne dekhe ho, so that is what is the commando training in Belgaum. It happened, and they have a base in Himachal also. So anyone who has to go to special forces has to go through this. Okay, so Mohit made up his mind ki nahi, attempt to karna hai, agar fauj mein hai to commando hi banna hai karke. And then Mohit was posted into infantry. Infantry is the first line, and they are the people who are the front line. So Mohit was from the Madras regiment. Mohit was posted. See the unity and diversity of Indian armed forces. He's a Sharma, but posted in a Madras regiment. That is the beauty of armed forces. Agar koi इट्स नॉट कि अगर आप गुरखा हो तो गुरखा रेजिमेंट, इट्स नॉट दैट इफ़ यू आर अ सिख देन यू आर इन अ सिख रेजिमेंट, इफ़ यू आर नॉट अ मराठा इन अ मराठा, इट्स अदर वेज यू नो. सो मोहित वॉज पोस्टेड विद द मद्रास रेजिमेंट. नाउ इंटरेस्टिंगली ऑल ऑफ यू लिसनिंग टू मी, मद्रास रेजिमेंट का वॉर क्राई, हर रेजिमेंट का वॉर क्राई होता है, तो मद्रास रेजिमेंट का वॉर क्राई इज वीर मद्रासी अडिकोलू अडिकोलू, वीर मद्रासी अडिकोलू अडिकोलू. दैट मीन्स ब्रेव मद्रासी हिट एंड किल, ब्रेव मद्रासी हिट एंड किल. सो मोहित वॉज पार्ट ऑफ द मद्रास रेजिमेंट, यू नो, अ प्राउड मद्रास रेजिमेंट. So he was an infantry. This was the first thing Mohit went into when he went into army. So when you join armed forces, you know, every officer of armed forces, any tri service, every soldier of armed forces, everyone is hero. You know, unko sirf ye sikhaya jata hai academy mein, they are the best. And पहले होता था ना, हम देश के लिए मर मिटेंगे, नाउ द फंडा इज चेंज, हम देश के लिए मार मिटेंगे. सो वी ऑल हैव बीन डॉक्ट्राइन टू दैट, देश के लिए मार मिटेंगे, मरना इज पार्ट ऑफ दैट, हुआ तो. सो दैट्स हाउ. सो इवन व्हेन कैप्टन विक्रम बत्रा, आई एम श्योर ऑल ऑफ यू नो परमवीर चक्र ड्यूरिंग कारगिल वॉर, सो व्हेन ही वॉज आस्ड कि विक्रम, व्हेन ही वॉज आस्ड ऑन हिज आरटी कि वॉट नेक्स्ट, सो हिज आंसर वॉज वेरी वेरी क्लियर, Either I will come back after hosting the tricolor or I will come back wrapped in it, but I will be back for sure. You know, this is what Vikram Batra had said. This was a very famous line, and this echoes with each and every soldier who's in armed forces. You know, so this was that's how Mohit was in Madras Regiment, and Mohit got his first commendation, first army commendation from the army chief when he was in his first stint in J&K, and he received the army commendation then. Then 2004, of course, he joined the special forces. He underwent training with one of the training for the commandos, and then he joined for his probation in with one of the RRs, you know, Rashtriya Rifles. First time during his probation, during the first attempt, Mohit was unwell and he couldn't clear his probation for the special forces. Now, many a time what happened, it's so tough that agar aapke paas first time nahi hoga, to you are broken. Matlab chhod do yaar karke, why? I don't want to attempt this twice. But iska jununi kuch aur tha, Mohit ka junoon was totally different. This guy went back to probation and in same Rashtriya Rifles, same RR, and the officers, they were very you know, like surprised that how can someone try second time going through the same torture, and but he cleared, he became a special forces commando. So Mohit became the was with the elite special forces. So this is the time when that incident happened in 2004, where he killed two terrorists, being there with them. So this became a folklore. For that, Mohit earned the first gallantry medal, Sena medal gallantry. So Mohit was one of those very few decorated officers who had won gallantry award twice before he won Ashok Chakra posthumous, you know. So the next part of the story goes, thereafter in 2004, he met his wife, who's also an army officer. She's, according to the book, she's a lieutenant colonel now, posted somewhere in Haryana. Hats off to her, hats off to Mohit's parents and sibling. So she's posted there. So Mohit met her in 2004, they got married. And the next 4 years, he was posted at Belgaon and thereafter in Himachal in the commando school. But everyone was knowing, and even he was knowing, this is, I am not meant to be, you know, being an instructor or in a base posting. My place is Kashmir in the front. And in 2009, Mohit, when he was posted there, his unit had a intelligence. Now this is the interesting part of story, that there is a infiltration by across LOC, and there are some 12 to 14 terrorists who had entered. So Mohit's team was tasked to go for the search operation. They called it as CASO, and along with the RR there, the Rashtriya Rifles, which Mohit was part of earlier when he was not a special force. So now he got a chance to be attached with them as a special force member. So this particular soldiers from that unit had sighted, the terrorists coming. So 12 terrorists, there is a forest there called in the Kupwara sector called Hapurdara Forest. And it's very dense. कहा जाता है in the book also it is written कि वहाँ इतना dense है कि sunlight भी नीचे नहीं पहुँचता. And during that particular time of the year in February March it was snowing there. You know, snows leg deep snow there. So the task became more and more difficult. And this soldiers ने बोला कि okay हमने यहाँ देखा है करके यहीं से terrorists दिखे थे first this thing. So अब काम क्या था कि उनको खदेड़ना है, उनको ठोकना है, सिर्फ सिंपल ढूंढ के ठोकना है करके. सो मोहित्स टीम वॉज असाइंड दैट. सो नाउ दे हैड 16 टू 18 पीपल इन देयर टीम एंड द इंस्ट्रक्शंस वेर वेरी क्लियर. मोहित वॉज हेडिंग दिस एंटायर ग्रुप ऑफ 16 पीपल एंड दे डिवाइडेड देमसेल्फ इनटू थ्री टीम. वन वॉज लेड बाय मोहित and Mohit's buddy. So buddy system in army date backs to pretty earlier, like during the world war. Buddy system is a pair of officer and soldier. So buddy ke liye, buddy will give anything, wo jaan de dega uske liye, and he will ensure that his buddy is safe in any time, you know. So Mohit's buddy was one now Hawaldar Rakesh, and he and Rakesh and his team, and there was Naib Subedar who was leading the other squad, and there was one more Hawaldar who was leading the other squad. So all of them divided themselves, and there was a scout who was sent to see ki kuch pair ke nishani milte hain ki nahi karke. So now is the tragic part. The scout, his name was, he was a paratrooper, Netra Singh. He went ahead. Someone has to be the lead. So Netra Singh went ahead. There was a small nala there over, and when he went and when he saw, he could trace that leg mark, and he could see some two or three terrorists there. Wo jaise usne unhe dekha, unhone bhi ise dekha. So and he alerted his team member, that is Major Mohit and other people, that okay, there is terrorist movement here. Before he could do anything, the first shot came to his head, and exact one shot forehead, and unfortunately Netra Singh collapsed there. This guy is of 22 years old fauji, jabki 22 years old hamare yahan, you know, lot of people spend energy in making a TikTok video, but then these are the people who are at the front. First shot and he was dead. जब फौज में कोई मरता है ना अपने इसमें, सो यू गेट दैट इट्स नो मोर अबाउट यू नो अ वॉर, इट इज़ अबाउट एवेंजिंग द थिंग. आपके अगर ट्रूप या आपके रेजिमेंट का कोई शहीद होता है तो फर्स्ट थिंग इज कि अब तो मारना ही है कुछ भी हो करके. सो एवरी वन ऑफ देम सॉ हिम फॉलिंग. सो व्हेन ही फेल, सो मोहित डिसाइडेड कि ओके नाउ द टेररिस्ट आर ह्यूज इन नंबर. And they are also like 16 to 18. Now it's a situation wherein they have to be very careful. Now the terrorist who comes along the LOC, they are not just ordinary people. They are also trained and totally brainwashed guys, and they are also equally trained like commandos. You know, so they know all the circle. They study the terrain. They comes. They knew when to ambush and when to play a surprise. All those things. So after Netra Singh collapsed, so Mohit and his team formed, took position separately. But the firing was so intense from the other side, from the terrorist side. They were like, they were having automatic guns and machine guns and grenade launchers, and they were firing continuously. Now, so the only way was to retreat back. you know, it would have been foolish to directly jump in the line of fire. So only way was to retreat back. So Mohit and his team, Mohit started telling people to retreat back. In the meanwhile, there was one squad of Mohit led by a Naib Subedar who was on top on a ridge. He could get a clear view if terrorist comes ahead. But unfortunately, terrorists were not coming out of hiding. So Mohit decided, there was one of his buddies, he told that particular colonel, his name was Rakesh, his name was Rajiv rather, Hawaldar Rajiv, that you fire from your end. The moment he started firing with his grenade launcher, one of the bullet pierced him on his left hand. So he couldn't do anything, he became immobile and then he fell aside. Now there was no option because Mohit wanted his team to retreat back and take position. At the same time, he wanted to maintain that covering attack. So what he did was, he just, somersaulted to the other end and he took the grenade launcher there from that soldier who collapsed. And then he fired some 4 to 6 round of grenade through grenade launcher. That somehow halted the movement of the terrorists, and this gave ample time for the people to retreat back, his soldiers. Now they were in a good position to fire on the terrorists, but as written in the book and what I could gather, terrorists this end were very strong. They knew all this and they somehow had upper hand. But because of this action of Mohit, somehow they got crippled there. But in the melee, when Mohit was telling everyone to go back, a lot of his soldiers or his buddies tried telling Mohit that you also come back. So ek hi tha usme ki yaar mujhe kuch nahi hua hai, aap log piche jaiye, main mera dekh lunga karke. And at some point of time, and he was continuously on his machine, and while retreating back and covering everyone, one of the bullets pierced. So you have a bullet protecting you front and back. One of the bullet, unfortunately for Mohit and luckily for that terrorist, one of the bullets pierced on the left side towards his heart. And that bullet proved to be fatal. So his buddy saw Mohit getting hit. At the same time, his buddy tried telling Mohit to come back, but एक ही ये था उसका, यू नो, नाउ सी दी जुनून होता है ना, कि ही स्टार्टेड टेलिंग टू हिज पीपल कि यार मुझे लगा हो तो भी ठीक है, बट एक भी बच के नहीं जाना चाहिए, क्योंकि दिस इज़ द टाइम वेयर वी आर इन द आर्म फोर्सेस, हम साले इनको खदेड़ने के लिए तो यहाँ आए करके, सो लेट दैट गन बी ऑन वेदर आई एम देयर और नॉट, और मुझे तो कुछ भी नहीं हुआ, ये तो ऐसे ही ठीक हो जाएगा. एंड देन मोहित स्टूड विथ बोथ हिज गन्स, both his machine guns, और एक झाड़ के सहारे, there was a tree there, and he kept on firing, that gave advantage to our soldiers this side. Close to around 8-9 hours after that, his buddies could see Mohit getting silent, and then eventually, at some point of time, when his buddy checked on him, so Mohit had martyred. So there was no regret to his, he was till his last moment, he was only of that ki maro inko karke, but at any cost it should not, he kept on firing. But by the time they got other battalions of army came and they got cover, and when Mohit was evacuated, when his buddy and others took his now lifeless body to the chopper to save him, so his buddy narrates that wo tabhi bhi wo, he was still warm, you know, he was still warm, aise lagta tha ki Mohit abhi, Mohit sir abhi uth jayenge karke, but unfortunately it couldn't happen and Mohit martyred. So the his buddy describes beautifully in this book is that that burden of taking Mohit from that spot where he got shot to the chopper remains the heaviest burden of his life even today. And every day he remembers Mohit. So Mohit martyred. Subsequently, in 2-3 days, all the terrorists were killed, and 16 terrorists were killed, and Mohit himself shot some 6 to 8 terrorists. So such was the brilliance. The officer martyred at the age of 32 rather. He was 78 born and 2009, so at the age of 31 he martyred. And his wife still serves in the armed forces, and parents are still, his brother is there. And so anybody who joins the special forces now in that unit, every day they remember Mohit. And if he, it is said that he was a very great singer, Mohit was a great singer, either he had guitar in his hand or a Trevor 21, his rifle, you know. So these were the two things. And his favorite song, uska pyara gana do hi hota tha, all of us, he was a big Kishore Kumar fan, I understand. Pal Pal Dil Ke Paas, and the song Pyar Hame Kis Mod Pe Le Aaya. So Pyar Hame Kis Mod Pe Le Aaya, it's a beautiful song. Pyar Hame Kis Mod Pe Le Aaya. So for Mohit's case, it was that love for country, love for motherland. वो मोहित को उस मोड पर ले आया. एंड ही नेवर रिग्रेट्स बिकॉज ही सेज कि मैं आई जॉइंड द फोर्सेस ओनली फॉर दिस. सो टू एंड विद दिस स्मॉल स्टोरी ऑफ मोहित विच इज़ अ ह्यूज स्टोरी. व्हेन मोहित वाज ड्रेस्ड इन दैट कश्मीरी अटायर एंड वन ऑफ हिज सीनियर कॉल्ड हिम व्हेन ही वाज गोइंग अहेड, मोहित कैप्टन मोहित जरा सुनना. सो ही सेड कि सर आई एम नॉट कैप्टन मोहित, मैं तो इफ्तिकार भट्ट हूँ.
जय हिंद.